What will get me to come off of my December hiatus? A fan's choice. I mean, a Robot Paradise review, that's what.
T-Man 978, chill review.
Hello everyone, T-Man 978. Right now I'm going to be taking a look at the Robot Paradise RP-01B, Cassetticons, Corvus, Shadow, and FIRRIB. Yay. Here are their tiny bios right there. That's their cassette mode images. And yeah, I like that they went with fur rib. I thought they were going to go with rib fur. So I'm thankful they didn't. So this is the exact opposite of fib rear, which means frenzy is red, rumble is blue. And the red guy, frenzy, was frenzy is blue, rumble is red. So what are you getting this overpriced set? Just like with this big guy in the back with fur rib, you get his cassette inside of the cassette holder right there. They all feel heavy because they're made out of a substantial amount of diecast. He has two extra heads and the pile drivers. Of course, he comes with his collector's cart right here. Here is the little bio right there, same as on the box. You get Shadow, Ravage, and his cassette box. You get his collector's cart, same short bio that was on the box. All the cards are credit card quality, if you didn't know. This one is Corvus. And same bio that was on the box. And of course you get the instruction manual back there. They come in a plastic tray instead of a styrofoam tray. For the anal people that want me to cover everything, there is a opening like point right there so you can open that up and remove the cassette. And there are little pins in there that hold them inside of the little wheel. I mean the, what do you call that? The tape turner. Here is fib rear out of acoustic wave right now. You can see they're very similar. It's just a black outline instead of a blue. And right here, reverse colors and whatnot. And the paint, as you can see, has like that metallic sparkle to it. Just like this one and just like acoustic wave. Right here, I'm going to show you that you can put two of these in here now that I have two compatible cassettes. You have to make sure that you put it in a certain way. It's like kind of shifted over to his left side on the inside right there. So we get him in there, and now we can actually slot this in here. Come on, slot in there. There are little grabby points, and I don't know what the heck is stopping me. Yeah, it's in there. Now he can have two cassettes inside. This is what it looks like inside of acoustic wave. And I have a Decepticon sticker there. Pull that out. Pull this lever. Get him out. You can push that back down there. We can put fear rib in there. And then we can grab Shadow right here. Him inside. That's what that looks like. And here is what Corvus looks like. There you go. I think I like Corvus the best in there. And if you don't know which is the top and which is the bottom, they have pictures of how they orient it right there. So, I mean, you could do whatever you want, but that's the suggestion. And let's see, I haven't tried to put Shadow or Corvus in the back there. So, let's actually try that. Now, messing with these or putting these in there is kind of scary because they are painted and made out of diecast. So it's scary to think that you can scrape the paint off. So be careful or do this at your own discretion. Let me try, just for completion's sake, try to push shadow back here. Yeah, it fits in there. Okay. Trying to make sure everything's pushed in. There we are. And let's see if I can open this. So, unlike the original Soundwave, I have not gotten these stuck in there. I like it. Alright, let's get FIRRIB out of the way since we already did FIRRIB. Same issue as the other one. This doesn't seem to want to peg in. It's iffy on whether that's going to stay tabbed or not. It's thin, but yeah, you might have to worry about this. This is actually kind of, is way looser than that one. I have the gun stored in there. The easiest way to do this is you just bend that right here. Then we can stretch the leg out. And I'm going to grab the foot, slide it forward. And honestly, this heel is very tight in there. So I'm just going to cut the middle man and use my spudger to get that out. If you are someone who watches Transformers third party videos and don't know what a spudger is by now, what's wrong with you? But I'm going to put a link in the description to spudgers on Amazon. Every purchase you make helps out my channel because it gives me money. But yeah, I have the weapon stored in the legs, just like with FIRRIB. Gonna pull them out. They peg into a little peg spot right there. Gonna take them out. Bring the arms down, fold them out like this. Stretch the body so it can actually have a full body. The hands are up in here. Gonna take them out. Take them out. All of these are super simple, scary simple to be honest. They're only like slightly different from their G1 toy counterparts. Technically he's a robot, but the finishing touches, we need to grab here on his little guns, pull that up. Open that up right there. And I'm gonna move Soundwave because the camera loves them. These things are tiny as is. But get that like that and you're good to go. Same thing with the other one. I'm not even gonna try to zoom in on that. But basically, we need the little nubs showing right there. And the little nubs go into his back. Inside of those little holes right there in his back. And now he is his full self. Same as previous. Hollow legs, hollow back, and looks good from the front. Here is an image of his G1 cartoon self. Of course, you can take these off the back. Take the back little tab, jab that into his hand, and now he can hold it like a gun. This is his basic face right there. If you slide it back off of the mushroom peg, like this, you can grab one of the other heads and put that on. And same as the previous robot that looks like him, the guns do not like to stand up back. Here is the happy face right there, and here is the pissed off face. Head rotates, can't really come forward, but goes back due to the transformation. Arm goes up like that. Joints are super freaking tight. Bend right here. Rotate. In fact, I didn't even never notice. I never noticed that this can't go all the way up. It can only go up 90 degrees. So you'll have to bring the arms up there. You can bend here at the elbow more than 90 degrees. The elbow goes out sideways. There is no bicep swivel, which sucked about him. And the previous version, there's no waist. There's no ab crunch. You can do side tilts on there to give him some attitude. The leg goes all the way back and more, all the way forward and more, all the way out to the side. But like I said, this one is kind of loose. Let me try this one. That one stays a bit better. Swivel here. And you have double jointed knees, but you don't even need the secondary joint to do that. The ankle is on a ball joint up in here. So you can get a bit of pivot and the foot rotates. The foot can come all the way forward and go all the way back. Made out of diecast. In fact, like the whole upper torso basically is diecast. The lower leg is diecast. I don't think there's diecast in the arms, but this guy is heavy. Here are various comparisons to other robots that are in the Masterpiece line or Legends line. Masterpiece. Official Masterpiece version of that guy. G1 style body for that. The other one basically looks like that, but more this color. This went more with a super duper cartoon accurate body because these two right here, because it's purple instead of blue. The original toy was like a blue and lighter blue, but like I said, in the cartoon it was all purple and blue. Right here is Shadow. As you can see, it's a tape detail printed on one side and not the other, much like the original G1 cassette right here. These cassettes are thicker than the Masterpiece and original, and that's why, and I believe the originals are longer. And the Masterpiece are longer. That's why they can't fit inside of Acoustic Wave. Here is the Masterpiece version right here. Completely different transformation. This is super similar to the G1 toy. Like in every single way. Except they integrated the guns. But let's get that going right here. You can actually just pull the head forward. Get that out of the way right now. Now we can detach these feet from the tail. And I guess we can pull them down to give us access to this stuff right here. You can pull the tail back like that. These guns, like this. Some of this does feel a little bit flimsy and it scares me, but you see this is a double hinge. I say flimsy, but some of the joints are tight, so it just makes it scary to move. I think I loosened it up, but once we get that down, we can bring out this little wings. They like to put wings on the missiles back in the day. So bend that, bend it on a double hinge, get the wing up, which is easier said than done because some of the joints are tight. Get this down, get the feet down, and the hips on the rear legs do hinge out right there. Well, there we are with this. Now the front legs, it's the double hinge situation again, but right there. Bend that and then lift this up. You know what? Now that I've transformed this once, it's easier to do because things aren't as tight as they were. Now, there are two little hinges right here. that flip in to here. I'm guessing they're supposed to grab the body, but meh. Meh. And now we can bring the arm down. And here he is. Here he is in his Jaguar mode. Things that are different on one side. Of course, you still see some tape detail right there, unfortunately. You don't see that on this side. There is a peg in the leg right there and a hole on this side because that's where they peg together. Here's that detail compared to the official masterpiece. I think this looks better. It's an upgrade because it definitely has more of the shape and design. And let's zoom in on the head. The head looks definitely way more cartoon accurate. And the mouth even opens and they painted the inside of the mouth red. The head can move a little bit on a ball joint and it can rotate left and right that much. Of course, the neck can do all that. And let's zoom back up. You want to do that. But the legs only do this. And they bend at the knee and the foot goes up and down. There's no outward motion like at all because of the way it transforms. The legs, on the other hand, go in and out like this. So there's outward motion on that. You get rotation right here. And this is on a ball joint. But you don't get a lot of outward. Do this, do that, and the toe does this. The tail can come down, but it don't look right. And the missiles do not rotate or anything because they're just on the hinge. There is no type of waist or midsection articulation in any direction. So, you really got to work at getting him in a pose. Naturally, he looks a little bit better than this flat thingy. And has more articulation. This has... I think most of the main body is die-cast. This has the die-cast in the lower legs. And of course, the missiles are bigger and shrunk down on. They're bigger on this. But you know, on the cartoon, they didn't do that. Big weapons. Here's a comparison with the masterpiece Ravage. As you can see, it's bigger, just like the Rumble Frenzy. But yeah, it's way more cartoon accurate. It just looks better overall. Cause yeah, look at this. This does have the midsection articulation technically, even though you only need to bend it like this so I can get the kind of shape it's supposed to have. No mouth articulation, no head articulation besides this. But yeah, you can watch. I got a video review on this and the other Masterpiece Soundwave cassettes. All in one video because they came in a box set. I like this one more. Okay, Corvus. As you can see, this all inclusive. You can see the guns and whatnot. Right there. Different transformation slightly, but still similar. And the sculpting is, they were strict to the sculpt. They didn't try to even make a completely boxy shape like they did with G1 Laserbeak or Masterpiece Laserbeak. But the transformation is way more similar to the actual G1 toy in certain ways, especially the way the head transforms, the way it slides up. But let's get into that. I'm going to lift the wings up like this. And then this can bend on a double hinge. I'm going to rotate this gun in that way. because halfway here, it needs to be there so it can get out of the way. But even before that, sorry, I need to grab the head and slide that forward so it doesn't get trapped underneath of the guns. But let's do that again. Start bending, rotate the gun in this way, lift this up, and once you get here, you should be able to get around the gun, and now that's there. It's the same issue with the Masterpiece where, I mean, this sits flush, but on my Masterpiece figure, I felt like I couldn't get these, like, straight at the angle I wanted without, like, fighting with it. But now the feet can come forward on that hinge and rotate, and the wings can come down, and you have to rotate them a specific way, it seems. I don't know. I think it's letting me do it now. No. That mushroom peg wants to fight. But here we are. It looks great. The chest has more of that G1 cartoon shape where it's angled. You see the face. Of course, the barrels on the gun, I'm going to push them flat to the body, are die-cast. Most of the body is die-cast. And it's not a major upgrade over the Masterpiece, but it's still an upgrade. Like, you can flap the wings up and down right here. I think that's not on the Masterpiece. And you can rotate them right here. And of course, you can bend this. And you can flap the wings forward like that. The legs are basically the same. You can do that and rotate. The head can go up and down and bend here. Unfortunately, there is no neck rotation. I'm shocked they didn't do that. And you still have this panel right here that's supposed to be the camera that comes out of his head. But he is what he is, nicely detailed. I like him. I think he is the Frenzy. I mean, the Rumble is okay. Whatever you want to call him. To me, that's Rumble because of the color scheme and the cartoon accuracy. Here's the comparison with the Masterpiece. They're close to the same size. The head is more big and detailed on this guy, of course. Yeah, they are super close. I think, yeah, the Robot Paradise has a wider wingspan. Yeah. You know, they kind of have the angle look right there beside the neck. This still doesn't have neck rotation. And like I said, the wings don't rotate on that joint right there. They just go forward like that and bend right here. Of course, you have the Decepticon logos right here. I'm going to have to look at the cartoon image to be reminded where the Decepticon logo needs to be, if that's actually accurate. It might actually be accurate. And of course, you still have the gun up here on this. And here is the rear. Come on. A little bit more detail on the Masterpiece. The feet look a little bit more cartoon accurate with the Robot Paradise. And if you have acoustic wave, and of course you do, you see that little nub right there. He has holes in the bottom of the feet. So you can pick which one you want and plug that in. And now it can sit on there and you don't have to worry about him falling off. Of course, unless you shake it around too much, but that is what it is. And it appears he has the same thing right here on the shoulder. Let's do this. It's kind of hard to grab at that foot. But yeah, there you are with that. He actually has it on both sides. Good luck putting it on the other side with that gun in the way. I never thought to try this, but I cannot get this to sit or to peg on with the original masterpiece as far as pegging onto Acoustic Waves arms. This peg appears to be wider than the grooves right there. So I'm not even going to try to force it. But overall, I like these. I like the Laserbeak. I wish it had a neck rotation. That's my main gripe with him. I like the Ravage. It's always been a chore trying to pose him in like realistic cat poses, especially with certain pieces of key articulation missing and whatnot. I mean, you can get him into some type of pose, like lunge or hunch forward like that. And I like that it has an opening mouth and it does have a ball joint. Seems to be able to turn this way. Nope. Depending on how it's angled, you can turn it more left or right. And of course, the rumble is cool. Just besides the things that I mentioned. I already have an instructional video on how to transform this guy back to cassette mode, and the video where I show how to transform this guy. Plus, I think I just showed it both ways in the full review. So we only have to worry about the Laserbeak and the Ravage. So here's what we're going to do. We're going to rotate these wings. We're going to lift them up like that and bring the feet down like this to have them in their orientation. Now we can rotate this right here and bring that down into that position. Oops. Going this way, we don't have to worry about moving this. So there we go. Put that there. Rotate it this way. Rotate this. Bring that. And now we can put this like this. Take the head, straighten it, and shove it, the neck down into there. And now we can bend this way. Make sure that that's flat right here on the double hinge. Make sure you flatten the double hinge. And now, boom, it's a cassette. The Ravage. What I'm gonna do here is start with unclamping these clamps right there. Pull that outward, grab this one, and pull that outward. Okay. I'm going to lift the arms back up, or four legs, like that. And we could, if you want to, bring the head back to now and shut the mouth. But I'm going to bend this double hinge down like this. Bend the double hinge down like that. Go ahead and squeeze, or try to make sure that the double hinge is straight. That's the hardest part with he and Laserbeak. Peg the legs together in the front. Actually, let's worry about that less. We can go ahead and shove these little hinges in that way though. I'm going to squeeze the hips in like this. And you know what? Come on, get in there. For whatever reason, this peg seems to be difficult. But there we go. Alright. Now I'm going to bring these feet up. Bring this tail that way. Right there. And now this foot needs to come down and peg onto the side of the tail. Bring the foot down straight. Peg it on the side of the tail. and why I wasn't worried about pegging this at first, because it likes to come loose because it's not a very tight grip. But there we go with this. Now these things, we need to rotate these on a double hinge. I'm gonna lift the wings up this way, but rotate that on a double hinge. And now we're good to go. It's a cassette. If everything is straight, should be able to fit an acoustic wave. There we are. So, yeah. I like the set. It is overpriced, but you gotta pay to play. So, there are no other options. If you don't buy these things now, typically the price just goes up. So, they got you by the balls, to be honest with you. Just like Takara-Tomy. If you want them, that's what you gotta pay. Takara-Tomy prices rarely go down. They get super higher because people want these things. They might reissue in the future. So, me personally, if I miss out on the original release of something and the price goes up more than 10, 20 bucks, I can't do it myself personally. I just will go without. I don't give a crap. But you have to decide if you didn't buy these things when they were originally released. And I think they might still be selling this. That's up to you. I got this from Toy Dojo. There's going to be a link in the description for Toy Dojo, or a link to this set if it's actually still available. And I'll even go ahead and put the link to Acoustic Wave. So, there you are with that. Thank you for watching this. Until next time, T-Man 978, out of here.
Figure action. That one's me. Join the Syndicate Toy Hunters Facebook group. Link in the description.
Click the videos. Click the f***ing videos, baby. Click the videos. You should really click these videos.